tonight we will be cracking into two boxes of Legion's Realms at War. We are going to open up one of these little guys, the Bountiful Harvest, which is just 5 packs, but they are all universal cards. I can go in any Legion's deck, and is the first or season one of this series. So I would expect there to be more of these coming down the pipeline with the expansions that this game is going through. And we are going to also be opening the first set, a box of Ravaged Lands, first edition, in hopes of finding something special, of course. But we are opening these in celebration of the Kickstarter that Legion's Realms at War is having right now. And I've actually got that up here. So if you were interested in taking a look, it is an extensive a tier list of things that you can take a look at. Everything from $40 up to $1,000. If you even find this game to be remotely interesting to you, I encourage you to come take a look at this, as they have a ton of information about the new set that they are promoting here, which is massive, their biggest set to date, and also it's going to revolutionize gameplay and things like that as well. But that being said, the gameplay from what I've seen has been extremely dynamic. So this game has what it takes. It has legs, and now it's just about keeping things moving forward for this very, very heartfelt attempt at a TCG. Let's see it go places. As you can see, lots of tournaments. You got the print runs from all the original stuff as well. You'll see some things that are out of print. That doesn't mean they're out of stock, so don't panic. That has been something that's been brought up in the Discord. There's still lots of things out there. I went to my store today and bought this box. So you could still get boxes of things out there. That being said, it is limited, so there's only so much of it. What's up, Cardboard Cohort? Good to see you. And welcome in, another major staple of our community here in Legion's Realms at War. And as you can see, there's tons of information, including how to play the game. The newest tier that's been added is actually the lowest tier, so it's $40 Canadian, and that will get you in at the starter level. So this is what I bought first. Essentially is like a dual deck if you're into something like Magic. And it gives you 2 base decks to learn how to play. And those also give you all the pieces that you need to play the game. So it's a great investment. You also get a couple packs. And if you get lucky, like, I don't know, maybe I did, I don't know, you might hit one of the most pricey cards in one of those 2 packs in your starter kit here. But as you can see, lots and lots of content here. I won't be going through everything here today because it makes no sense to do that. I want you to do that on your own, but I wanted to show you all the start here, as that is a big jump for this company, but also for this game. Very exciting times, and the Kickstarter has just begun. So if you're interested, go check it out. Hello everyone, and welcome back to another opening here today. I have in front of me some more Legion's Realms at War. This is very topical, as Legion's Realms at War has just launched its own Kickstarter. We want to be sure to send our love and our excitement their way as well, as they look to create their most expansive set to date. But they have also already done so much for this game in their first year of operation. So definitely a lot to love here. I wanted to open something I've never opened before, which is a Bountiful Harvest set. So these are all of the, I always forget what it's called. Let's see here. It is the, oh my goodness, Bounty. Thank you. I don't know why that one always sticks with me. But yes, these are all Bounty cards, and that means it says right in the name. All of these cards will be able to be played in any Legion's deck. So this is season one of this. It's a pretty awesome way to enhance your decks. And they are, of course, quite a bit smaller. So a little bit smaller of a price tag as well. But looking forward to getting to that. And then we're going to open something we've opened a lot of. And that is, of course, the Ravaged Lands booster box. That is my goal here.
Nice.
We are still hunting a lot of things in this set, including our boy from the Angels. We want to go ahead and find Calf Seal as well, hopefully, but who knows what's in this box. But we are going to start here with this, and I will be sure to include a link to the Kickstarter in the video description here, so go ahead and check that out. It's just gotten underway recently, so lots of time to get in on all of those sweet, sweet rewards.
Just do it!
All right, remembered my sword this time. 3D, how's it going, man? Good to see you. Yes, least favorite set, but one of the most important. I agree. I mean, for the universal cards, I kind of get why it's sort of crucial. So there should just be five packs in this box.
This is disgusting. This is awful in every way.
And a box topper. So let's take a look here at what we got. And there's my box top. Oh, I mean, of course, it is a bounty card. That makes sense to me. So we've got Ancient Relic, Key of Chaos. Pretty lovely. Yeah, super important indeed. Yes, yeah, so I got to learn the game a bit more over the break. I love the look of this card, by the way.
It's beautiful.
I'll try and make sure I get the foil without just catching the ring as well, but looking lovely. And then, of course, standard backs, as I believe all of them are. All right, we got five packs. These are beautiful packs, by the way. Really, really eye-popping. So, looking forward to seeing what's in these. In this set, it says there are, has the rates on the back here. So we've got, so there are 40 commons, 20 uncommons, 8 rares, 3 renowned rares, and 1 exalted rare, and 12 foil box topper exclusive. So that would be the one that we have. So that those are the rates that we're going for. Hitting a renown in these 5 would be awesome. There we go. I swapped the pack for one that just has exalted rares in it, so just so you know, just so I'm not spoiling the fun for everybody. All right, so if you're new to the game, this is where your Legion symbol is. In these 5 packs, you will only see the book, which is the bounty cards. So we have a common here. I don't know the order of things. Another common, Alberdoon's Fall Festival Fruit Bearers. Endless Bounty, looks like it belongs to the giant clan there. All right, into the uncommon. So there must be a couple commons at the back. So standard with the second set there. I cannot do it savagely. I'm sorry. I have a lot of finesse. You know, look at the mask on that Magic Mask Merchant. How about you get a little little Skull Kid in there, eh? A little bit of Skull Kid action. Everyone, pass over your exalted real quick. All right, there we go. That is our last uncommon there. Caspian, the famous musketeer, and our rare is a rare, and it is Dynamite Dice Dealer. Oh my goodness, quite a bit more explosive. Now we should have a couple of commons. We got a doe, a deer, it's a female deer, a bazaar that's full of lots of fruit, Defender of Alberdoon. I could not continue with the rhymes. I'm sorry to all of my friends. I'm also wary of the fact that, you know, these are cardboard, you know. I've damaged cards in the past. Pulls a Ren, that'd be kind of cool. Better get the muscles in there, Mrs. Fathom. Yeah, it'd be, if the wife wants to get in here and open a pack, by all means, happy to have her in. I believe she's doing a little bit of baking for us, which is exciting. Magic Ranger Scout, Spirits of the Brachus Pond. Ooh, Deflect. Love that. Beautiful. So I actually need a couple of these for my deck, so glad I got one of those. Great Sound of Music reference. Thank you. Yes, very topical, the Sound of Music these days. All right, and we have our last there, which is Arbor... Is it Alberdoon or Alberdun? Looks more like the dwarf folks there. Is Alberdun the dwarf stronghold? Port Heritage, and we got a rare Magic Blade Dancer. Go. We've got Time for Harvest and Pilgrimage to Alberdoon. So it looks like we're getting there. They're all Alberdoon. There you go. In Alberdoon Trade District, Trader's District. All right. Into the next one. I'm just going to go ahead and quickly use the other method. There we go. I know the Ravage Lands packs will open a bit easier for me. These just these have some qual packaging. What can I say? Qual packaging. Look at this Magic Mask Three-Eyed Dark. Look at that thing. That's ridiculous. Looks crazy. My goodness. Chant of Preservation. Looks like an angel card. Heritage Hamlet. Stroff the Fire-Breathing Satyr. Very interesting. The Sarensada? Maybe I should pull a Sarensada. I think that'd be great. Traveling Magic Mask Wagon. So there's the guy, the Magic Mask dude. And we've got Severed Connections. That's straight out of Hercules. Absolutely, that's from Hercules right there. You can't tell me it's not. Look at that. Those weird one-eye Sharon sisters. And we have another rare. Ooh, that is a double up on the rare slot. Seems pretty unlucky, I think. Although there are only 8 rares, I believe, in this set, so. Miss from the Fata Morgana. And Aberdun's Target Competition and Harvest Moon. There we go. Miss is great. There we go. 2 more packs left. I would love to hit a renown in this one. That would be huge. I'm not expecting to get the only exalted out of here, but it'd be pretty freaking sweet if it was, but hey. More Aberdun. Is Aberdun like a collective centralized civilization, or is it specific to one of the legions? Festival fireworks. I think, or is it the world? It might just be the realm itself. Festival clothing, closing ceremonies. Hey, redouse the dice. Gotta love that. Pick up their power. Magic mask, sad gold. So it looks like there's a magic mask series. And a rare by order of the reliquary. Very fun. So that is our rare for that pack. We have magic plants, the future seeds. And hidden shop of magic. And a fruitful farmer. All right, last pack in this, and then we'll into the Ravaged Lands box. All right, will we hit that renown? Or will our luck continue? We got the Plague Doctor sitting right up front here. Looks like Dante, the mysterious physician. Festival Feats of Strength. Second Acolyte of the Reliquary, Dismantle. We have Aberdun Street Entertainment. The Coast of Admission. And our last rare is a rare. Seasons of Magic Reflections. I was like, we get 2 of the same rare. No, we did not get 2 of the same rare. So it looks like a 5 rare box here. But hey, gotta start somewhere. Sawmill on the Brachus. We are guaranteed some shiny goodness in the next one. But that was my first look at this Bountiful Harvest. And you'll see here we have our 5 rares. We do have a double up, unfortunately. I was kind of hoping not to have that. Hopefully it's a useful one. There we go. Those are our 5 rares. You can tell the rarity on the bottom if you're new to the game. If you're not, ignore me. Just ignore me. You know what you're doing. You know what you're doing better than I do. And then, of course, our box topper. Cool. All right. And here we are. Ravaged Lands once again. So we are going to do all of this in one shot. We're going to make it perfect box. Who knows what's in here? If you are in the game itself, if you know the cards, take your guess as to what my renowns are going to be. And you know what? You may as well take a guess for my exalted as well, because I'm owed one after getting entirely hosed by my last box. Brutally, it was a box of Frontiers, but I got absolutely trolled. Okay, let's get these out of frame. Let's get into it, shall we? Into the Ravaged Lands. All right, so one thing I've noticed on these is there's not really much you can do about the edging on the back of the cards. That's a printing thing. But hey, I'm still in love with the artwork. And the foil quality is usually quite good. On a couple, you can find some roller lines, but it's really quite quality for a first crack at something like this, for sure. There's our girl, is our warrior token there from the Angels. Oh wait, not a token, sorry. I realized we can do our thing. There we go, snow puppers. We can do our pack trick, that's fun. Every time someone opens the plastic of a Ravaged Lands box, collector cries knowing it's rare and highly collectible. A void? I do have a void. I do have a void holo already. Yes, definitely collector, and I am a collector, and that it does pain me, you know? I wanted to sit, but also I love opening, and I want a full set of this.
So he's an idiot.
So we have our Frost Puppies to start off here. We got Petrella, the Putrid Groundskeeper. We got Escape from Explosion Mountain. We got our Lady and our lovely Angel art. Use that for one of my thumbnails as well. He's going to pull a Demon Guardian. Ooh, interesting. Cavern of the Careless. Now we're into the uncommons. We got spooky, spooky skeletons. Hey, From Open Clouds They Fall. Little angel hit there. We got Mystic Fire Beast Power. And our rare is Tall Shield from Ancient Stormhound. So there we go. Starting off with a hero. Hero rare there. Pretty lovely. Pretty good. We'll see where we go. I'm going to guess in the next three packs we hit one of our foils. So just for all of you to know, the seeding is basically two guaranteed foils, renowns per box. And then you might get something additional. Ooh, Fire Chicken. Fire Chicken always means good stuff. Fire Chicken always gives us the goods. Fire Chicken bringeth the value. Some orc action. We got Brand of Tarth. Basically every Titan lady I see here is Brand of Tarth in my mind. I don't know. We got is that Milady? Milady's Putrid Burial Ground. That's pretty fun. Blast Forge Extreme. There we go. Seraphim Punishment. Great card. A lot of fun. We've got Blast Forge Expulsion Cannons. Hey, Valley of Magic. Always nice to get one of those. And we do have a rare. It is Return of the Primordials. All right. Demon Guardian, eh? I'm trying to think if I have the Demon Guardian. I don't think I do. So that would be a welcome hit. All right, let's take a look here. Our token, it looks like our Fire Chicken let us down, did not bring the heat as was promised. So we're gonna have to trust in the absolute anarchy that is these red cards, man. These demon, that red is so vibrant. The camera doesn't do it justice, but it is insanely bright. Our hero, we got Shattered Reflections. Every time I look in a mirror, we got What I Wish My Beard Looked Like. We got What I Wish My Beard Looked Like. We have that one time the wildlings climbed the wall. Unstoppable Power Bond. Pretty interesting Titan card there. We have the Upside Down Dwarf hanging from the ceiling, and we have Cara Delevingne from the Suicide Squad. Actually, sorry, Suicide Squad, not the Suicide Squad. But there she is, encased in sprite magic. Very fun. Enchantress makes an appearance today. All right. Let's get some fire going here. I want to see some flames coming off of these things with all the heat. There we go. Lower Principalities, my token. Let's see what we can get. We have a beautiful Lady of the Water. We have Brand of Tarth. We have what appears to be Jon Snow after the Battle of the Bastards. Ah, beautiful. That reminds me of the glade that the mermaids hang out in Peter Pan. The original animated Disney Peter Pan. We have the Holy Nun there. Hidden Hands of the Hood. There we go. A bit of spooky, spooky uncommon angel. And then we have it looks like an orc engineer. Pretty crazy. And then Blast Forge Melt Cannon. There you go. That's a minor hit there. Useful card though if you are playing on the dwarves. Very, very useful. All right, if I'm right, that means I'm pretty sure I have to hit one of my foils in this pack here. Will we do it? Time will tell. We're starting with the boar, and you can be a big pig too. Angelus, Demon Eyes. My boy, my goodness, just so majestic. Less majestic. We got the full moon. Now we're into our uncommons with our dwarf friends here. We have a hero lad. We have Vault of Black Magic. And we did not hit what I thought we were going to hit. So there we go.
Liar!
Nothing left but Putrid Plague. That's how I feel. That's fair. Nothing left but it. That's okay. Nothing left. We're just getting started here. We're about a third of the way through the box. No anti-magic yet. No renown hits yet. But hey. Sad indeed, noob. But hey, we'll get something. Don't you worry. Maybe it'll be in this rotting skeleton pack, you know? Nothing crazy, Folly. Nothing crazy. We're just settling in. We're ready to hit the renown in this pack. We got angels back to back, so you know things are looking up for your boy. Have a few drinks on the dwarves. Ooh, another angel. Nice little angel pack we got going on here. Gross and unstoppable, unbreakable. Okay, so I'm going to say we're whiffing. We're whiffing pretty hard here. Need to see what we can get. But nothing has happened yet. This pack is suspiciously tough to open. I'm going to say there's nothing in here then. Because if it was hard to open, that means someone's already opened it and taken all the goodies out, you know? That's got to be how it is out of a sealed box. All right, Titan Token, Orc Boy. We got our beautiful elk in the field, hanging out, chilling, Bambi's dad. We got our Titan friends, some heroes, some undead boyos, and we're into the Orc camps for the uncommons. The demons, the angels, and there we go. We have a renown. What renown do we have? Land of Defiance. There we go. So, and I guess in honor of Bountiful Harvest, we're going to open up the Bounty Renown here. I believe I have this one.
I did not.
But hey, beautiful card. I think it's like 25 or 30 bucks, I think. But just taking a look at it, I am seeing one roller line right down the middle there. I'm not sure if there it is. You guys can see it. There it is, rolling right through the lightning. But look at that thing. Remove those angel counters, exactly. Pretty crazy. Absolute counter for my deck here, but it is beautiful. Very fair. Very fair. And very pretty solid lack of curling. I do see a bit of edge wear there, so came out of the printer looking hot. But hey, that's our first one. It's okay. We still have two more foils in this box, folks.
Are you sure about that?
We have our other renown. Remember I said nothing was good in that? That means I'm going to have to declare that nothing will be good in the rest of this box. There's nothing good in this box. Just a fiery hellhound there. We have a spooky mess. We have a robot unicorn attack. To the heavens. Reign of Tarth. Minas Tirith. And we're into our uncommons. The Hellsteed. We have a dragon, mythical beast dragon. We have the prince, who was promised, and we have Trap in the Black Powder Room. My goodness, we are getting lots of dwarf rares, I think, actually. So that's interesting. Yeah, fair enough. That's true. From my understanding, if you're playing a counter to angel, like it'd be good in a deck that maybe struggles against angels, it might help from my mild understanding, but if you're playing something that already does pretty significant damage to them, you don't need them. Fire Chicken, Bountiful, Sky City, we got Dude in the Cave, looking spiffy, our pixie friend, my beard envy, we have Order of the Phoenix, we have Straight Up Attack on Titan. This dude, I got nothing about him. He just looks menacing. And looks like an angel card. And it is. It's a bow of the archangels. Very cool. Very cool. I do play a couple of these in my initial deck. It's actually sideboarded right now, I think. But hey, I do need one for the collection. So I welcome that with open arms. There's a card, if holy counters are removed from the field, they go on a card in the angel deck's land. That's very true. I play that card, so that makes sense. Yeah, if it's removed by anything other than combat, right? They get put elsewhere. Snow Puppers! More Robot Unicorn Attack, but this time my face in front of it. Spooky, spooky. The artwork in this TCG is great, and I am a fan of the color coding. I find the swoop to be kind of big, but other than that, I really do like the identifying factors. And especially when they get foiled, they do get their foiling color as well, which is really cool. That happens to be gray because it goes everywhere. All holy counters, even combat. Interesting. Now I might not be playing that card then. Ooh, our demon. Look at this. Look at this demon jester here. I don't know if I've seen that uncommon before. It's crazy. Hero rare, and we got Grim Grimoire chapter 2. I do have both chapters now, so we're done with our chapter collection. Really, we're looking for that big hit, you know. We're doing that big hit. I'm hoping to get one of those to celebrate the Kickstarter, as I haven't opened a Exalted hit since the very first pack in my starter deck, which was crazy. That was a nuts moment on the channel for sure. More angels, lots of angels. Come on, Cassiel, why don't you show up and we'll hang out and be friends or something. All right, we got Demon Boy here walking through fire. Oh, this is a thick pack. Okay, this is an excellent pack. Pretty sure I don't play angels, to be fair. Yeah, fair enough. All right, let's see what we got here. Well, it's an angel token. It's a fat one. There's nothing good in this pack. Nothing. Has to be nothing. We got our sea dragon. We got our beautiful, the water temple. I think this is the water temple from Ocarina, from Majora's Mask, I would say. We got hiding within the crowd there. It reminds me of the Assassin's Creed Brotherhood trailer. We got me on a Tuesday night. We got me on a Sunday night. And we are into Order of the Phoenix Part 2. We got a dude literally wearing a bear. So that's pretty cool. We have an orc camp. This reminds me of the camps in Valheim that you have to go through. And we've got Rally Sharn's Faithful as a orc rare there. All right, this will mark the halfway part of the box. So you tell me, folks, are we hitting the Exalted here today, or are we striking out again for the fourth time? Boy, my goodness, this one's struggling. Get some assistance from the sharper part. Okay, we got token. So the reason you can't flip this over is if it's an Exalted, it's upside down in this pack. So I don't want to see it before I get there. Shambling Skeletons. We have the Bard. We got Fluffy on fire, I guess, having a bad day. Don't know if I must have seen this one before. Interesting, the secret supply entrance, holy eyeballs, and there we go, we got our demon lad, our anime boyo in the uncommon slot. We got some angels doing very unholy things to that skull. We have a mythical beast. This looks like the fairy from Ocarina or from any of the early Legend of Zeldas, but definitely from Majora's Mask.
Okay.
I do not want to get my hopes up because I got absolutely railroaded last time. But there is a very good chance. Very good chance. This is an Exalted rare. 5 stars. Let's see what we got. Yeah, baby! Kindle Host! Polly, I found him! I found him! Kindle Haas, there he is. That is an Exalted rare. Too little, too late. No, it's not. I need one too. Check it out, my dwarf boyo. Blast Forge Fire Sparker, the Exalted rare. Finally, we've hit one. Unbelievable. The Haas man knoweth no limits. Look at that beard. Straight glory to Kindle Host. That is an exciting continuation of this box. My goodness, look at all those stars down there. That's crazy. Okay, well, I just want to look at it.
How would you look at that?
Boom indeed, Stumbies. Boom indeed. Check that thing out. Not sure what Kindle Host is sitting at right now, but I'm very happy. It wasn't my boy. It wasn't Calf Seal. But hey, It's an exalted rare. That's all I wanted. Why are these so tough all of a sudden? Was it at the beginning of that pack that I said, if you look at the back, if it's an exalted rare, you'd see it? So the reason you can't flip this over is if it's an exalted, it's upside down. Let me just test something real quick. So the reason that you can't definitely money noob. that pays for over half the box, if not nearly the entire box. Okay, so now I have to say it again because superstition. If I were to flip this over, we might see the exalted rare, and therefore I have to keep them shuffling from that way. So there is our Titan lad. Ooh, how bow to the fallen. My goodness, that is that a cape or wings? That's great. Those are wings. Look at that. That's insane. All right, spooky cave. Whew, on an absolute high after that. We got deer in the field. Bambi all grown up. We got the bag of putrid demise. The bag. The bog of putrid demise. It's a bag of putrid demise. That is that's the nicest looking Brienne of Tarth I've ever seen. That less so, less nice. That's pretty crazy. And we have a rare here. Fandorian Flail of Castle Thorn Haven. There we go. Dude wearing an actual lion for a hat. That's pretty crazy. Yes, putrid bags. Okay, I just want to look at it again.
It's beautiful. Dang,
dude. So now I've pulled a Void Hollow and a Kindle Host. Today. I picked it up today, Folly. So don't worry. There was no chance that I could have had it before today. Gotta love some of that action. Don't worry, I'm not holding out on you, my friend. And there's our token. You could be a big pig too.
Oi.
All right. We got the piggy. We got the mad cow. We got the Windows Vista. We got the Serengeti. We got spooky eyeballs in the night. And we've got the absolute, I hate these. I hate the demonic sisters. It's kind of creepy. I don't love it so much. All right. Mystic Fire from the Golden Urn. And just another uncommon here. We got Gibbery. And we've got Phoenix Flames Conflagration. And that is Order of the Phoenix Part 3. We're starting on. Okay. I am still expecting another foil in this box. I still am. I don't know which one. I am expecting it. I'm hoping it's a new one. We've already added one major new one to the collection, which is very exciting. And there will be many sleeves that are passed around after the video ends. We got a token. Never Shake the Cold. We got the Ice Spear. We got Defending Minas Tirith. We got Defending Minas Tirith. We've got people heading to Minas Tirith. We've got one of the orc generals from Lord of the Rings as well. Crazy looking dude. We've got Grim Smiles of Death. It's kind of intense. Hey, we got the hot air balloons. It's pretty crazy. Not a while ago, but Atlas only had like 8 left when I got mine, so I'm guessing there's 2 boxes left there. It could be one more exalted unless it's gone already. Yeah, they were there today when I left, so. And we have a rare Black Magic Hellfire. All right, I'm going to guess we got maybe 8-9 packs left. If you're enjoying what you're seeing, I do this on occasion. I stream Minecraft as well. I'll be doing that after. Drop a follow as we're on our way to 500, trying to get there. Snowpuppers wishing us nothing but the best. Ew. I hate that one. It's really Gunungi. Stumpies, thank you and welcome aboard. You are crewmate number 464. Nice number. Love that. And we have the rogue. This is the rogue in the D&D party. There's always one. Oh boy. Spooky. That's in my dreams tonight. All right. The Matriarch of Grim Agony. And it is a rare. It is, Lance of the Lost Messiah. So another angel one. Not one that I play, though. Has to be said. Not one that I play. All right, so there is rumor that the Exalted takes the place of a Renown, but in my other box that I did get a Exalted in, I also got 2 Renowns, so Fingers crossed that we're hitting one of those today. Hero, I need a hero. Someone said I was getting the Demon Guardian, right? So I guess we have to get that. It's right in the predictions. We can't disappoint the crowd. So shiny. Oh my goodness. And there. Okay, here we go.
I'm not the Messiah. I say you are Lord, and I should know. I followed a few.
Here we go. Hey, it's Raylene again. I do have this one. Let's see if this one's cleaner. Ah, there's a nick right on the top. The face is so clean. I really liked it, but yeah, my edges are all... That's true, actually. Great point. What a dwarf box. Rock That's nuts. Stone. Looks like I'm playing Doris Folly. Sorry, I'm stepping on your toes here.
Bacall!
I actually even look at Kindy to see if he's got roller lines. Minor ones. Actually, he looks really good. Like really, really good. Oh, might be a small nick there. We'll get him in a sleeve. But there we go, Raylene. Everything's kind of gravy after hitting an exalted rare, so I'm feeling pretty good about this box. But yeah. Big on the dwarves, apparently. Big on the dwarves. So one thing about building decks in this is you can only have one of each exalted rare, and you can have two of the renowned. So it's nice that it's not prohibitive. You don't need four Kindlehosts, you know, to be competitive in this game. Matter of fact, the decks that come in the starters can also be played, like genuinely just played as they come out. Obviously enhancing them makes them a little bit better, but they're still relatively good when they come out of the box, some of them anyway. So if you're interested in the game, definitely a good one to start on. That's funny. Normally my foils are behind this guy, but not today, my friend. We have the sword and we have Wrath of the Doom Drake. There we go. I believe that one's actually worth a couple of bucks, maybe 7 or 8 bucks. I'll take it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 packs left. What will we find? So that means I pulled a Void Hollow and a Kindlehost. Not too shabby. We got Pumba. There's Pumba. Got some angels, some undeads. We got a little bit of that demon action there. Dragon Whelp. Flail. We got the dude with the spiky hair and teeth. Spikes are his whole jam. Spooky Snake. Just a straight up rock beast. And we've got Marvin's Ancient Text. It'd be awesome if we can get an anti-magic, actually. We haven't hit one in a couple boxes. So that would be lovely. Lovely, lovely. But we'll see. We will see. There we go, starting off with the skeleton. Moving into our eagle or a fire chicken all growing up. We got some views. Hey, we got, I don't even know this one really. Yeah, Seraphim High Blessing, interesting. Dude's got no arms but has arms. It's kind of sneaky. Okay, got another guy and a bear. The dwarves like the bears. We got a dragon. We got more dwarves. Man, this box is dwarf heavy. And we've got Uthril Blesses, the Orcbane Chosen. Also a couple bucks on that one, so. Feeling pretty good about the value of this box. I'm also just looking for things that I need. Unfortunately, Capsule is really the big thing that I need. I don't think I'm going to get a double Exalted box, you know? I don't think that's going to happen. All right, let's get through here. Hey, we got the RGB cords here. Got to keep the lights on. That is the worst art. It is ridiculous how spooky that is. Spooky. There we go. We got the Mimeoplasm. We got one of the named orcs from the Lord of the Rings and Order of the Phoenix Part 4. So, Rebirth in Phoenix Flames, indeed. Two packs left. And then that'll wrap things up here. And then we will be continuing on the stream as well, if people are interested. All right, Fire Chicken in our second last pack here. Fire, Undead, Dwarf, Titan, Angel Sweetheart, Book, Spooky, whoop, We are in. We got Spooky as an uncommon. We got those lads. We have Gozer from Ghostbusters. And we've got, okay, the Grand Ale House. Man, they really want us drinking tonight, eh? My goodness. All right, here we go. The last pack. Can we get some last pack anti-magic, perhaps? That'd be pretty cool. And we got a token here. It is a fiery hellhound to start us off. More demons. Hero. Broken glass. Awesome beard. Awesome beard. We got a book. DK. And then our last one is... I don't think I have that one, actually. Forever Unstoppable? Interesting. That'd be okay to actually work out on or end off on a new rare for me. So there we go. Well, folks, that has been one heck of an opening. Those are all of our rares. As you can see, they're sorted by color on the edge there, which is pretty cool. But the real big news is, of course, our two renowns here. Our Land of Defiance. Technically, all of these can go in a dwarf deck, and we have our Exalted Hit in Kindle Host, Blastforge, Fire, Sparker. There it is. Well, that is going to do it for this one, folks. As I mentioned at the top of this, please check out the Kickstarter if you are interested. There's a lot going on the Kickstarter itself, so you will be able to take a look at a number of the awesome things that they are working to get towards, including the new set Empires on the Rise, which will be absolutely massive. So if you're interested at all, go check it out. Support this incredible game as it continues to grow, and I'm sure to be opening more of this in the future. But until then, please take care of yourselves, take care of each other, but most importantly of all, stay hydrated, and I'll see y'all next time.